and good afternoon. I'm Tracy Sinclair here with Alaska's News Source. And with me today is our investigative producer, David Bernkoff. And David, this morning, the Ombudsman released a report about some allegations that were made over a year ago toward Mayor Dave Bronson's administration. There were six different allegations that were looked at. Kind of give us a quick overview, and then let's step through some of the what the result were. What were some of the complaints that were made?
Right. So first, I want to back up. All these complaints are related in the sense that the same person filed them. So that's why they came out. The report came out. All of them, although they don't seem directly related, they're related in the sense that they deal with the mayor's administration and that they came from Amy Domboski, who was the mayor's municipal manager until she was fired, and then just before being fired, and also then afterwards, she pursued not only a lawsuit for improper dismissal, but also filed these complaints with the ombudsman who works for the municipality. And he took months and months and months. This was late 2022, and it is now I believe March of 2024, and the report finally came out. And there's a reason for that, because some of them are complicated. Let me start with the most complicated one, and maybe the most consequential one, and the one that there's no resolution for.
Okay, so there were six allegations.
Six allegations.
Four they found had either some merit or this one that wasn't,
right.
They're not quite sure of, and two they dismissed.
Not justified. Not supported.
Okay, so
One that was, it's number six on the list, and this is a copy of the quite detailed report here. There's a lot of information there. You can go to our website. We have the entire report as well as a couple of responses from the administration to the report. But the final item in there, number six, involved the mayor's policy advisor, a guy named Larry Baker. He was alleged by Domboski to have gone to the municipal attorney to try to intercede improperly on an issue involving a misdemeanor charge of domestic abuse against one of Mr. Baker's business partners. So the allegation is Baker goes to the municipal attorney and says, can you drop the charges?
Okay.
What the ombudsman found after an investigation, Mr. Baker denied it completely, but two executives who worked in the administration said they were told by the municipal attorney that this allegation was true. You might say, well, what does the municipal attorney have to say about it? The municipal attorney said, until this matter would come up in potential court actions, I'm not going to speak about it. So the municipal attorney, who's now not the municipal attorney, declined to answer the question. And because of the lack of clarity on this, Baker says it's not true. Two people say they were told contemporaneously that it was true. He did not make a decision on whether it's true or not, but he felt it was serious enough that it should be forwarded to the Alaska Division of Special Prosecutions for them to investigate potentially and make a decision. So there's no decision other than it was serious enough to forward on to legal authorities who could decide don't do anything or prosecute.
And so that's the six on the list. What were the other three that were considered justified?
Well, the other ones, one that was considered justified, an interesting one, because it involved allegedly an intentionally made decision to violate municipal code by allowing more homeless people to stay in Sullivan Arena during the winter than the fire code allowed for. And the argument was, we have a moral imperative, we have to save people's lives, we're just gonna let people stay there. The counter argument from the ombudsman was, you can't have a system where people decide to violate the rules and the laws because their moral code says to. And he said, very interestingly enough, Mr. Hess, who used to be homeless policy director, he said, if it were me, I might have made the same decision because you're dealing with people's lives. But when you are the ombudsman, you have to look at this and say,
interesting,
it's an intentional violation of the law. You shouldn't do that.
So they knew what they were doing was against it,
right.
But they did it anyway,
right.
Because,
right.
Yes, so that is an interesting kind of position to find yourself in,
right.
To see that. That's
another one This is one that it's just sort of weird to talk about, and so I'm going to go through it kind of quickly. There was an employee who admitted on at least one occasion to bring in some cookies that she shared with fellow employees that one would say were inappropriate. They were cookies shaped like male genitalia. And
she brought them in on more than one occasion.
She admitted to one occasion. She denied it on the second occasion.
Okay.
Six people who worked for the city say, no, she brought it in on a second occasion as well. This was clearly an improper thing to do. Her response was, it was a one-time thing. I learned my lesson. Why are you making such a big deal out of it? I'm never going to do it again. So that was one that was deemed justified. When you go through this, one other one, the sole source contracting, that's been an issue not just for this administration, but for other administrations, because to do a bidding process takes time. The only way you're supposed to be able to do sole source contracting is if you certify that there is no one else in the municipality who can handle the job, therefore there's no reason to ask for bids.
Right.
The Ombudsman found that that was being abused and that there were other potential bidders and that that was a violation. But again, he made a point of saying it's the same thing that other administrations had done previously, and the Assembly needs to figure out a way around that because it's been abused before. It was abused again by this administration. One that was found not justifiable was a claim that a municipal employee improperly checked the homeless database. There's a database of people when you apply for aid, and it's supposed to be confidential. There was an allegation that someone had improperly accessed it. He said he found no evidence of that. And then the other one that was found to have to be justified,
not justified,
was that the mayor's senior policy advisor was retained as a contractor rather than hired as a municipal employee, and that was a plan to circumvent certain retirement policies. That he could not make that connection, and so he found that not justified. And those are the six. And the mayor's response this afternoon, a statement saying these things were dealt with in the past, it's old news, and oh, isn't it coincidental? They didn't use the word coincidental, but pointing out that this is coming out right before an election, and maybe there's a political motivation behind it. We asked the Ombudsman that question today, and his statement was, there's always an election, and if I didn't release it now, that would be political. You can't win for losing. He did say that one of the reasons it came out today was because the mayor had recently vetoed a bill dealing with the authority of the Ombudsman, and it wasn't until last night that the Assembly overrode that veto. So he wanted to wait until that issue was settled before he released this document. I know he had told us that he wanted to have this report out as early as last December. Then he said it was ready in February, but the administration wanted time to look at it. So his explanation is, this is when it came out, it was done, and there's reasons for that. But it clearly does come out right smack dab in the middle of the mayor's race.
Right.
And it can't be anything other than political in that sense. I'm not saying that what the motivation was.
Right,
but it is political now. It's an issue now in a race that people are voting on today and for the next 10 days or whatever. So
does anything happen from here? Are there any other steps that go along with now that we know that he's found at least three of them justified,
The Ombudsman makes some recommendations in here for policy clarifications, policy changes. The administration has not yet reacted to those specific recommendations. The Ombudsman did point out that in a recent report he did on a totally unrelated matter, he made several recommendations about how HR, human resources, should handle things in the future. They said the administration accepted all five of the recommendations. So sometimes they accept, sometimes they don't. Remains to be seen on these issues, whether we'll hear anything before the election or not. And then we're also working on a story today, not only about the substance of the report, but the political reaction. Again, two separate stories. There's a report that has a lot of detail on it, and then there's the inevitable political reaction.
Right, because as you said, whether it was intended to be political or not, it is now political because it is out and we are less than 2 weeks away from the actual mayoral election. So thank you very much. David Bernkoff, he is our investigative producer here at Alaska's News Source. And as you heard, we will have more on tonight's news at 4, 5, 6, and 10 about this issue. So please join us there. And of course, you can always find us on our streaming platforms on Roku, Amazon Fire, and Apple TV.
And again, for those who want to read it, the entire 20-page report and all the responses to it are on our website.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Thanks for joining us.